हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू डीएडएमए। होप आप सभी का प्रिपरेशन अच्छे से चल रहा है। तो हम कंटिन्यू करते हैं हमारे प्रीलिम्स रिवीजन सीरीज़ के साथ। तो इस रिवीजन सीरीज़ में हम लास्ट 1.5 ईयर का करंट अफेयर्स कर रहे हैं एंड हियर वी आर कवरिंग करंट अफेयर्स फ्रॉम साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी। ओके, तो इस लेक्चर में हम क्या कवर करते हैं, हम मिसिलिनियस एरिया से कवर करते हैं। तो एज यू नो वी हैव ऑलरेडी कवर्ड स्पेस एंड डिफेंस रिलेटेड टेक्नोलॉजीज, वी हैव कवर्ड द हेल्थ एंड रिलेटेड डिजीजेज एस्पेक्ट्स, and we have also covered various issues related to cyber security. Okay, now we are covering the miscellaneous aspect from science and technology. तो इस लेक्चर में हम देखते हैं इंटरनेशनल चार्टर फॉर स्पेस एंड मेजर डिजास्टर्स, उसके बाद हम देखते हैं ग्लोबल अलायंस टू एलिमिनेट लिम्फेटिक फिलेरियासिस, उसके बाद वी विल टॉक अबाउट द ग्लोबल अलायंस फॉर वैक्सीन इनिशिएटिव, आफ्टर दैट वी विल टॉक अबाउट द COVID-19 सॉलिटरी रेस्पॉन्स फंड, आफ्टर दैट हम देखते हैं हेमोस्टेट मटीरियल के बारे में, आफ्टर दैट हम देखते हैं हंटा वायरस, बायोरॉक और मिनरल एक्रेडिशन टेक्नोलॉजी, आफ्टर दैट वी विल सी सक्षम, व्हाट इज सक्षम। तो चलिए शुरू करते हैं। तो फर्स्ट वन, इंटरनेशनल चार्टर स्पेस एंड मेजर डिजास्टर्स। व्हाट इज दिस इंटरनेशनल चार्टर? इट इज अ नॉन बाइंडिंग चार्टर वेयर व्हेन देयर इज अ डिजास्टर इन अ कंट्री, इन अ मेंबर कंट्री, देन द इंटरनेशनल एजेंसीज विल शेयर देयर सैटेलाइट डेटा विद दैट कंट्री, ओके, विद दैट कंट्री फॉर द ह्यूमैनिटेरियन एड। It provides data for charitable and humanitarian related acquisition of and transmission of space data to the relief organizations in the event of a major disaster. It was initiated by whom? Initiated by European Space Agency ESA and the French Space Agency CNES. Okay, initiated by these two. India during its Assam floods have received data from a member countries like France, Russia and China. So that is the international charter. Next one, the Global Alliance to Eliminate Lymphatic Filariasis. It's an alliance of partners from 72 LF endemic national country programs, NGOs, private sector, academic and research institute. So all these are alliance partners in this. So it is a global alliance to eliminate lymphatic filariasis. Okay, so various international developmental agencies are included in this. It's a program of WHO. It's a program of whom? WHO. Next one, Global Alliance for Vaccine Initiative. So this Global Alliance for Vaccine Initiative is a global health partnership of public and private sector organizations dedicated to immunization for all. Immunization for all is one of the major global initiative. So it is a global health partnership of public and private sector organizations for that. It is backed by several global NGOs and global in a global health related organizations, including the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation. This belongs to Bill Gates and his wife Melinda Gates. Okay, so after that, even WHO is involved in this, World Bank, the UNICEF. So all these are involved in this, and they will arrange for bulk buys to low vaccine, you know, at a low cost. The bulk vaccine is being bought at low cost for the people in poor countries. Okay, it is for global immunization, immunization for all. It's an initiative of various organizations like Melinda Gates Foundation, WHO, World Bank and UNICEF. Next one, the COVID-19 Solitary Response Fund was in use. This is a fund from the United Nations Foundation and Swiss Philanthropy Foundation. This was created to support WHO and partners in a massive effort to help countries to prevent, detect and manage the novel coronavirus, particularly those where the needs are greatest. The COVID-19 Solitary Response Fund is created by the United Nations Foundation and a Swiss Philanthropy Foundation. Okay, this is to fight against the novel coronavirus. This is to support WHO and its partners in the fight against the novel coronavirus. Next is hemostat material was in use. What is this hemostat material? The hemostat material is developed by the Institute of Nanoscience and Technology, INST. It's an autonomous institute under the Department of Science and Technology, DST. It is starch-based hemostat material that concentrates natural clotting factors in the blood by physically absorbing the excess fluid. So when the blood clotting fails, this hemostat material can be used. Okay, so this is developed by Nanoscience and Technology, which is an autonomous institute under the Department of Science and Technology, DST, under the Ministry of Science and Technology. Okay, so hemostat material, remember, it is for clotting of blood. Next one, Hanta virus. So recently after coronavirus, this Hanta virus also was in use. This is not a new virus, it's an old virus, but recently it was seen that people are getting affected by this Hanta virus also. So what is this Hanta virus? This Hanta virus is in the Yuan province of China. It is found in Yuan province of China. So key facts, what you have to remember, from whom this disease spreads? This disease spread from rodents like rats and all. Okay, spread by rodents. इट रिमेन्स अनक्लियर. सो टिल नो वी डोंट नो दैट इट विल स्प्रेड फ्रॉम ह्यूमन टू ह्यूमन और नॉट. इट इज पॉसिबल और वी आर नॉट इट श्योर ऑफ दैट, बट इट इज ट्रांसमिटेड फ्रॉम रोडेंट्स टू ह्यूमन्स. ओके, ए पर्सन इन्फेक्टेड विद द हंटा वायरस मे शो सिम्टम्स विद इन द फर्स्ट टू एथ वीक. सो एज यू नो कोरोना वायरस हैज जेस्टेशन पीरियड 1 to 14 days. सो विद इन 14 days यू विल नो वेदर द कोरोना वायरस इज हैज अफेक्टेड यू आर नॉट. But Santa virus, it has 8-week gestation period. So it's a long gestation period. Okay. So this affected person will take up to 8 weeks to show the symptoms. So when they have been exposed to a rodent's urine or a fecus of the rodent and all. Okay. The symptoms of this Santa virus include fever, fatigue, muscle aches, headaches, chills, and abdominal problems. All of these are the symptoms of the Santa virus. That is why this was in news. Next is the BioRock or Mineral Accreditation Technology. This is very important. So recently, the Geological Survey of India has introduced this new technology of the. It is a new process, a new technology to restore the coral reefs. Restoring the coral reefs. That is the main use of this technology. How it is used? Using the BioRock or Mineral Accreditation Technology. It was first tested in Gulf of Kutch in Gujarat. Gulf of Kutch in Gujarat. So this BioRock is, it is a name given to the substance formed by electroaccumulation of minerals dissolved in the seawater on the steel structures that are lowered onto the steel bed and are connected to a power source. So I'll just explain you. So if you see in the sea, the steel blocks are sent. So these steel blocks, they are connected to electricity. And electricity is passed through these steel blocks. Because of that electricity, different ions, different minerals, they get deposited on these steel structures. Okay, they get deposited on these. So these are renewable structures. Okay, so when these get deposited on these structures, these minerals, then this becomes a starting point for a new life. This becomes starting point because minerals are there. The new animals, new fishes, they come and settle here. It becomes new settlement. You know, it becomes a new ecosystem for them. Okay, so this is how it works. It is sent, the structures are sent, then electricity is passed, the minerals get deposited on that, then it becomes a new ecosystem. It becomes starting point for the new ecosystem. That is about this. Next, Saksham was news. Saksham, it is a people-centric fuel conservation mega campaign. There are a lot of Sakshams. Okay, so one Saksham is this. It is with regarding to the mega campaign of Petroleum Conservation Research Association, PCRA. Okay, it is for the conservation of fuel. It involves a lot of oil and gas PSUs, the public sector enterprises, along with various stakeholders like the state governments. Okay, so this PCRA, the Petroleum Conservation Research Association, was established in 1978. It is a registered society set up under the aegis of Ministry of Petroleum and Natural Gas. Okay, that is about the Saksham, Project Saksham. And also this is about the campaign Saksham. And also we have Project Saksham. What is this Project Saksham? This Project Saksham is with regarding to the upskilling of railway employees. Upskilling of railway employees. That is the Project Saksham. This is about the campaign Saksham by the various oil and gas public sector undertakings. Now let's revise whatever we have studied till now. Okay. So first we have seen this international charter for the space and major disasters. So this is a charter where an affected member country, it will get support from various members. So the satellite and other related information is been given to them. Next we have seen about the global alliance to eliminate lymphatic filariasis under the WHO. Next we have seen the global alliance for vaccine initiative, which is the immunization for all initiative by various international organizations like the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation, the WHO, World Bank and UNICEF. Okay, so they buy the bulk of the vaccines at very low cost, and they will distribute that to the member countries, to the poor countries in fact. Next one, we have seen the COVID-19 solitary response fund. This is initiative of United Nations Foundation and the Swiss Philanthropic Foundation. These two have created this. Okay, this is particularly to fund the WHO and its partners to help the countries in preventing, detecting and managing the novel coronavirus. Next one, we have seen about hemostat material. This hemostat material is developed by the Institute of Nanoscience and Technology, INST. Okay, this was developed by them. It's a starch-based hemostat material where this is used to clot the blood. This is used to clot the blood, developed by Institute of Nanoscience and Technology, which is an autonomous institute under the Department of Science and Technology. Next, we have seen about hantavirus. Hantavirus was recently in news because cases have been found of hantavirus in Yunnan province of China. We are not fully clear whether it transmits from human to human or not. It is transmitted generally from rodents, like rats. Okay, so the gestation period is up to 8 weeks. 1 to 8 weeks is the gestation period, and symptoms include fever, fatigue, muscle aches, and all. Next, we have seen about the biorock or mineral accretion technology. This is the latest technology where we are trying to create artificial coral reefs, using various biostructures. Okay, where these biostructures they will be connected to an electric supply, the electricity, where this electricity, when supplied, you know, the mineral deposits will happen on these structures, and this will become a source for the new ecosystem to develop. So, and also this was started by the Geological Survey of India, and recently it was first tested in Gulf of Kutch near Gujarat. Next, Saksham is a fuel conservation mega campaign of Petroleum Conservation Research Association, which is a registered society established in 1978. It's an initiative of various oil and gas PSUs. Okay, so that's it friends in this lecture. I'll see you again in the next lecture. Till then, keep studying and stay tuned. Jai Hind.